We are growing apart, and sorry, we welcome you to our project. We are growing apart 2.0. We are Angelica from Germany. She's an architect. She worked the last years in Australia, in France, in Germany, and also Latin America and Argentina. And now she's mainly working with interdisciplinary research and architecture. Ceyhun Atyok, he's from Istanbul, Turkey. He's based in Berlin as well. And he's an architect. He worked the last years also with designer and architecture, and he's working right now with interdisciplinary research and group dynamics. And me, I am Juan, I am from Colombia, I'm based in Berlin, and I am working in also interdisciplinary research, but related with social complexity and startups. I want to invite you to my presentation, also here in the World Design Summit. Thursday at 11, it's 10:30, 11. I'm going to talk about how to use gamification and virtual reality games to explore forecasts and future scenarios in businesses. We are an open design team. We are a group of people that we met in Buenos Aires 2 years ago. We were studying a master's degree, then collaboration with Humboldt University from Berlin and Argentina, and the University of Buenos Aires. And we begin to collaborate between us to make projects related with research and architecture, design, arts, and human science. And then we are here by our sponsor, that is the Cluster of Excellence from Berlin. This is a space, a laboratory that allows us to work in with different kind of disciplines, as medical doctors, scientific field, and even hospitals, as the Charité in Berlin, one of the biggest in Europe, and also museums and all these kind of institutions to make research related with interdisciplinarity. That it's important to why I talk about that much about interdisciplinarity, because like yesterday, everyone was talking about this new wave of collaboration and this new way of how to connect people, how to add layers of information, layers of vision and diversity. And they were talking about also transdisciplinarity and co-disciplinarity, you can say. But it's super interesting about what we offer to you today. It's a vision that is related with interdisciplinarity. Interdisciplinarity is more related with synergy, that it's adding pieces from really different fields. We are creating something that is not actually the addition of the pieces, it's something related with something more, something bigger, something special. The project, the beginning of the project, this is the second stage where we are presenting. But the first stage in Berlin was a product of work, a collaboration of the work of Angelica, Ceyhun, and other person that is not here, he's in Berlin. He's Pablo Fernandez, he's a user experience designer from Buenos Aires. He works mainly with transportation, and he just arrived from Manila from one of the biggest conference related with this field. And we have also extended team that it's I'm Agustina Palermo. She's a theater director, also based in Berlin. She's working with games and analogic games. Benjamin Royal, he's a designer from Australia, Sydney, and he's also working in disciplinarity And Carolina Garcia, that's an architect, and she's working with spaces related with education. We came here to answer the question, how to design for the future, but how grow planning and urbans from?
So the question, sustainable development requires being at the forefront of and anticipating urban growth. How can we transform existing living environments so that they not only respect the capacity of ecosystems, but strengthen their balance and reveal their potential? What about gentle densification? What about urban forms will be best adopted to maximize the hosting potential for our neighborhood, of our neighborhoods, our cities, our metropolitan areas and regions?
So our project is Governo Park 2.0, as I said before, approaching the urban phenomena through an adaptive and iterative design strategy. We propose a transformative future through an adaptive approach by using multidimensional processes and interdisciplinary strategies to identify urban potential, the produce forecast up to the development of strategies for urban planning and management by applying an iterative operation. I will introduce now with Jaehoon, the first part of the presentation is going to be related with the first stage of the project that we presented in Berlin. In the Cluster of Excellence from the Humboldt University from Berlin. And the second part is the connection between the second stage of the project and the process, the methodology, what we did, what we want to do. And of course, at the end, we have the future projection, what we want to do, what we want to share with this, and what is the future. I present Jaehoon. He is going to continue with the presentation.
Thank you, Juan. I'm going to talk about the initial stage of project, what we developed before. As it is foreseen, 66% of human population will be living in urban geographies by 2050. And as a consequence, urban geographies will continue growing both demographically and physically. So physical growth can be explained as Batia Nombi's definition in fractal cities. Like all natural growth, they evolve through cumulative addition and deletion of basic units, cells, or particles. In the case of cities, such units may be individuals, households, firms, transportation links, and so on, represented in terms of the immediate space they occupy, and cities thus grow through successive accumulation at these basic scales. On top of this, the demographic growth is understood as the quantitative study of human populations. Demographers study subjects such as the geographical distribution of people, birth and death rates, socioeconomic status, and age and sex distributions in order to identify the influences on population growth, structure, and development. Here we take insights from two integrated themes to examine the directional growth. First is the geographies of encounter, which is the body of work broadly interested in social diversity, urban difference, and prejudice, which has sought to document how people negotiate difference in their everyday lives. Following this, we focus on the concept of meaningful interaction, described as that is a contact which breaks down prejudices and translates beyond the moment to produce a more general respect for the others, given existing structural inequalities and the forms of marginalization and exclusion they produce. Our project focuses on growth in the context of the city, more specifically on the conflict that might arise from the phenomena of growth. In this sense, we identified the process of growth with decreasing levels of interaction among different parts of the city. In the last decades, growth in metropolitan areas, as demographic and physical, has been exponential, which also implies structural changes. When the existing urban system is failing to adjust the changing structures, we can identify the phenomenon of growing apart.
Focused on the unique urban pattern shaped by the podcast.
transitional spaces in one topic of life are going, are pointing out the huge potential of the internet out. During the video, the semi-formal and semi-graphic area is exaggerated and extended to infinity, while affecting the total direction of stable place. Thus, it puts the observer in a position of isolation in such spaces that actually contradicts the essence of the space of the space of transition. As a conclusion of the visual project, the process of mapping, analysis, and envisioning offers a new perspective on the complexity of human interaction in the context of multidimensional urban growth. We realize that the extended boundaries of connecting agents are essential to preventing going along in the context of the exterior city. From transitions that attach to arising from such interactions, they are a crucial role in the other interactions, thus reducing the risk of high connectivity while the city is changing its dynamics and structures. From this perspective, the contemporary state of city can map itself easily to other developments. Once these boundaries can be mapped, extended, and introduced to profound interaction. To sum up, these scenarios are experimental thought processes and induce a critical vision of going about in the urban context.
Okay. I'm going to take over and have a question. Can you hear me, or should I take over the microphone? Okay. I'll try to speak up. Following up Jay Hoon's part, I would like to introduce you to our modus operandi, as we call it, meaning the methods, tactics, and strategies that we used in order to our work. This section is divided into two parts. Growing up Heard 1.0, as we heard, the project started initially as such. It represents the concept for urban development and is a wide-ranging study of possible development approaches for cities that may be imagined in very different urban settings. For the purpose of structuring our approach to the topic of urban growth, we applied a three-step method allowing an iterative application within changing urban contexts. Within the first level, we are mapping problems. The second level applies analyzing potentialities. And the third level enables envisioning alternative scenarios as we have heard from the project. As mentioned before, this method allows an iterative application and can be applied. The emphasis of the communication tactic lies primarily on visual narrative. Like a storybook, the proposed three-step process is presented as a continuous walk through text passages, graphics, plans, models, and other animation. Visual media is designed to be immersive and to bear the visitor away into different scenarios, which with each level increasing the immersion into the urban picture. Product strategy aims to activate critical thinking through an experimental thought process. The outcome focuses on highlighting potentialities by overstating the problem while revealing spaces of opportunity. As a continuation of the initial project, Growing Up 2.0 perpetuates further project developments by increasing the resolution of the concepts for urban visions. Therefore, some
strategy of Program Hub 2.0 focuses now on highlighting potentiality on one hand by the multiplication process called the quantitative development, and on the other hand by the intensification of the process qualitative. Well, at this point, actually, we'd like to address ourselves to you and invite you to an open call for collaborations. We want to do our part in approaching the phenomenon of urban growth and its consequences, and we're currently imagining two possible ways of connecting with individuals, professionals, sponsors, and institutions that would like to join us on this journey. As a first part, we imagine the multiplication of the process towards creating a network of cities all over the world. Here we need to define a model for development that can be multiplied in a varying urban context. Later, the applications of these different cities will merge into a web-based platform, allowing to enhance the visual narrative in the sake of tackling and tackling problems. Secondly, we would like to emphasize the intensification of the process, as we call it, designing, prototyping, and finally testing in the context. Here we started to connect with laboratories investigating at the virtual research and planning. ZKU, for example, is a center for arts and urbanistics on the list that offers us temporary residency within an interdisciplinary range of people, and we will be there from January 2018 on. It's working, and we would therefore like to invite you to join our work in progress with possible temporary visits. Other networks such as FAS in Paris offer us laboratory spaces to initiate and accelerate scientific, entrepreneurial, artistic projects. So in this stage, we imagine the exchange through temporary project collaboration worldwide. Summing up, we are interested to collaborate with individuals, specialists, sponsors, and institutions that show great interest in tackling the phenomenon of urban growth and its consequences. By connecting with a greater network, it will enable us to continue working on the project and generate knowledge beyond our singular influences. So here, that's the moment that we would like to thank you. And please feel free to have a look at the artifacts that we've installed over there, have a look at the merchandising and the blogs that we've brought with you. And we're very much open for feedback, critical questions, and just an open discussion. Thank you.
Bernardo Secchi and his team worked on the future of the city and its urban space. And I was wondering, in your method, at which point do you actually cover the ground? Do you explore the territory? Since you talk about mapping a lot, mapping is looking at the city from very, very high. At what point do you go down into the city and make your analysis, or complete your analysis?
Mapping is a certain tool to look at it in a bigger scale, but this is also why we chose these three cities, Buenos Aires, Istanbul, and Berlin, based on our own experiences within them. So the emphasis of this specific way of analyzing potentialities would also imply to be on the ground and have already an existing experience on the ground. We cannot expect to find these potentialities and also to define the right problems by just dropping in the cities. We have to somehow experience it on a longer term.
I would like to add also that, like Angelica was saying, it it's for us it's important in this case to have the vision of the local, the vision of the people who habitate actually the place, because it's the people who actually live in the place, know the space, and transit in the space. And I would like to tell you, for example, when we met, we actually had an exercise to walk to Buenos Aires with the map of Berlin. So it was a little bit confusing, but the idea was mostly to make a perception, jump outside of the boundary of the map that sometimes lead you to mistakes or just a path that is not, it's only the optimal path, it's not an enjoyable path. So this is what I'm talking about.
Can also be understood as a part of the whole vision paradigm.